Open the door, it's only me.
The new record is a fascinating look into him, try to find the answers in life. It's a classic redemption, apology, and search for the truth.
I have that desperate feeling. In trouble is where I'm going to be.
Most people within that search will somehow have to face down the idea of something larger, whether it's a God or, as he says in Kingdom, is there a kingdom beyond it all?
I know you hear me knocking, so open the door and set me free.
Hourglass sounds like the record Dave has always intended to make. It was a record that has always been inside of him, but probably could only have been made now simply because he needed to go through what he went through to get to this point.
Is there a God who loves you so? Do we believe in love alone? I'm still pretending I'm not a fool.
I finished a tour with Depeche, and it was pretty quick afterwards. Christian and Andrew, who I wrote some songs also with for Playing the Angel, we probably wrote maybe sort of 15 songs together and demoed them, three of which ended up on that album. But once we got together, it was pretty obvious that we were writing new stuff. I kind of still had in the back of my mind all the time that, like, I wanted to use some of the songs that weren't used playing the Angel sessions and work on them again, but we never really went there. But there was one song that I had started writing to that was Saw Something. And Christian had sent me these chords. And actually, when we were working in New York at Stratosphere Studios, I had those and I started writing these words, and this melody came in my head. And I almost went into the guys from Depeche, you know, to Martin Fletch, and said, you know, I got this other song, you know, I really think we should work on it, you know. But I bottled out at the end. It was right in the last sessions, and everybody was pretty fried, and I thought the last thing they really need is another song. And so I kind of put it away, but I kept working on it. It kept coming back to me all the time during the tour as well. And so that really was the catalyst that sort of started the idea to write again.
After the storm had passed, I wondered how long the break in the clouds would last. Something in your eyes, I'm sure. Baby, I saw it. Something in your eyes, I wanted it for myself.
Originally, we thought, well, we'll just demo some songs. And really, that was as far as the idea went, really. There was no kind of, you know, calling up the record company and saying, you know, come and listen to what we're doing or anything. We were really just kind of, you know, our own time, you know, it's my place. But within the first, like, week, it was pretty obvious that we were doing a bit more than that.
Yeah, we turned up not really knowing what we were gonna do.
No.
And I think, like, after 2 weeks, we suddenly then sort of decided, right, we're gonna make an album.
Still wishing for divine intervention to lift me from my chair.
I guess when we first started writing that song, I had that song in my head and in my heart. And so I kind of like, I was dying to sing it, to get on a mic and say, guys, that little piece you sent me, the Christian, I got a song, you know. And when I sang it down, Christian kind of gave me a look like, that's great. And it gave me some confidence because really I had no other ideas at all.
Usually the music's there before. Sometimes we start working on, you know, maybe just a keyboard pad or something. Dave comes up with some really good melody, but we don't have lyrics, so he would sing in some fantasy language. And then we're just looking at that and we're looking for the right words that sound a little bit like the take we recorded.
It's all been remarkably easy.
You and I, we've come so far, we've reached beyond the farthest star. Time and time and time again, I want you back. You were my friend. We can pretend.
All in all, I mean, we've written and recorded for more than like 8 weeks or something like that, which was pretty fast, to be honest. But it all started just pouring out. Once I started writing, I was just sitting down, Christian would be playing something, and like these ideas were coming, and I got my little book out, and I'm writing away.
Do have a good, even from like said the last time when we wrote for the Playing the Angel sessions, we have, for want of a better phrase, good chemistry, you know, it seems to work really well together.
Yeah.
I imagine it must be very exciting to find that when you've been through such a topsy-turvy situation with a band that you've been with for as many years as Dave has been with Depeche Mode. So one can only conclude that what Christian and Andrew did for Dave Gahan was that they allowed him to feel comfortable in that situation. And once you feel comfortable, almost anything can come out.
That certainly happens when, you know, when Christian and I sort of sitting there at the piano and writing, it's kind of like, sometimes I'm just like, it's gibberish. And we record that gibberish and, you know, what happens quite often, I'm listening back to it and there's a phrase in there that I'm hearing that I'm not really even saying, but I'm hearing this phrase, and you know, and what's that about? And I hear these words that are some kind of soul search that's going on within me, and I don't even know what that is, but you know, I'll be damned if I don't sort of die trying to find it.
Miracle?
I remember. You singing into a vocoder.
Yeah, yeah.
And me
playing bass.
Playing bass.
For half an hour.
For half an hour after a couple of beers.
And then sent the 5 minutes that we thought were good to Dave, and he just came up with the idea of miracles.
I don't believe in miracles.